A long, long time ago, nothing lived on the earth. There are plants and trees and rocks and things. Not a lot was moving unless it was moved by the wind, the rain, and the water. The animals, though, they were still around. They were up in the sky with Mrs. Moon. They'd look down at the blue and green ball, kind of the way we look up at the moon, and they thought it was pretty, but they didn't think much more about it. Well, most of them didn't anyway, except for Br'er Rabbit. He was always pretty curious. Every night, Mrs. Moon would go down to the earth, and in the day, her husband, Mr. Sun, would go, and Br'er Rabbit found himself wondering what they were doing out there. So one day he goes up and asks her, "Hey, Mrs. Moon, what you doing down there on that blue and green ball?" "Well, that's my personal garden, sweetie. And when I'm not there, my husband goes. And sometimes we even go together. It's our special little place, you know?" "Oh, that sounds mighty nice, Mrs. Moon. Hey, mind if I go and check it out?" "Oh, no. I don't think it's a good idea. We put an awful lot of work into it, and we want to keep it just the way we like it, you know?" "Shucks, so you're keeping it all to yourself?" "Yep, that's the way it's gonna be. Sorry, Br'er Rabbit." "Oh, man. By the way, Mrs. Moon, you're looking kind of thin lately." "Oh, really? You think so? I've been on this brand new diet. I think I'm looking better than ever." "I don't know about that, Mrs. Moon. I mean, we all like you plenty well when you're round. I think I look better this way. In fact, I'm even planning to lose a couple more pounds." And so, everything continued on as it always had. Br'er Rabbit kept up his curiosity, and Mrs. Moon kept up with her diet, even though it wasn't a good idea. After all, yo-yo dieting can make anyone mighty sick, even Mrs. Moon. And sure enough, one night, she ended up feeling mighty ill. "I think I'm going to stay home tonight and go to my garden after I rest up for a little while," she said to herself. And so, Mrs. Moon tucked herself into bed and got herself some rest. Now, this was what Br'er Rabbit was waiting for. He knew where Mrs. Moon kept her things, so he snuck on in and borrowed the way down to Earth. He figured as long as he was back before Mrs. Moon woke up and Mr. Sun came and visited, everything would be fine. And when he got down to Earth, he saw something he'd never seen before. There was grass to run between his toes and the wind played in his hair, and he ran and laughed all night long, returning just before dawn. All the animals were wondering where he'd been, and of course he told them he'd snuck his way down on Earth. And he told them how beautiful it was and how wonderful it was. And the animals could barely believe their ears. "Nah, Br'er Rabbit, you gotta be kidding us. Come on." "No, I'm not kidding you. In fact, next time Mrs. Moon gets it in her head to do one of those silly diets, I'm gonna show you myself." Sure enough, Mrs. Moon got in one of those silly diets again. She got all thin, she got all sickly, and had to take a couple more nights off. And, as soon as she did, Br'er Rabbit and the other animals sneaked down to Earth. And it was just as wonderful as Br'er Rabbit had said. The fish played in the waves, and the birds danced on the breeze, and the whole Earth was full of song and laughter. They all had so much fun, they completely lost track of time, and Mr. Sun came down to his garden as he always did, and he saw the place was absolutely full of animals. And he stopped and said, wait, how'd you all get down here? Aren't you supposed to be up in the sky of Mrs. Moon?" And they kind of blinked, yeah, but she's not well right now. She on another one of her silly diets." "Yeah, unfortunately. Don't look at us, we think she looks better round too." "I'm gonna go up and have a talk with my wife." And he did, and the two of them talked it over. Mrs. Moon wasn't too happy that they'd snuck down like that. Fact of the matter is, the animals had seen Earth now. They all liked what they'd saw, and they were so very happy there. Kinda seemed like a shame to send them all back to the sky. So they decided, well, I guess we'll let the animals stay, as long as they don't cause too much trouble out there. And so, the animals and fish and birds and everything you see today ended up living out on the Earth. Everything seemed to be going fine for the most part, except for the fact that Mrs. Moon started getting a little bit lonely. She was so used to the sky being full of animals, and now it was so very quiet. Just her up there, looking down, occasionally visiting her garden. Well, Br'er Rabbit felt kinda bad about this, and so he decided to climb his way back up there and come for a visit. So, if you look up in the sky sometimes when the moon is at her most round and most happy, if you look real closely, you can see a little rabbit up there visiting Mrs. Moon.